profound statements. Did I unshare this thing?
No, sir, it's nice.
Profound statements. What are compound statements? A statement which contains more than one elementary statements. Those are called compound statements. Okay. Let me give you a simple example. Let's say 18 is divisible by 6 and 3. Okay. If you look at these statements, this is a basically statement made up of two component statements, and those statements are 18 is divisible by
6 and 18 is divisible by 3.
And you have another statement, 18 is divisible by 3. And these two statements are being connected by a connector, which we call here as the AND connector. Okay. Now, this connector is basically represented by this symbol in logic. Okay. And such a statement will be called as a conjunction. Conjunction. Okay. So when you say P and Q, mathematically or symbolically it is represented as P up arrow Q, and this statement is called conjunction. And these two component statements are called conjuncts. These are called conjuncts. Okay. Now, I'm sure you would have done Boolean logic in your computer science in junior classes. Correct?
Mm-hmm.
Nothing? No.
No, sir.
Oh, ho. Anyways, Boolean logic is basically, you can say, a modern version of this logical reasoning that we had learned from our Greeks, which is applied to Boolean. George Boole was an English mathematician who applied that to Boolean logic, and that is used mostly in sort of electronic circuits, you know, NAND gate, AND gate, OR gate, all those kind of things. Okay.
Yes, sir.
For the purpose of simplicity, you can assume it to be the multiplication. Okay. Now, how does a truth table of AND look like? So something called truth table. What is the truth table? Have you heard of the word truth table before?
Yeah, 1100 and all, right?
So basically, it is a kind of a tabulation of what is the outcome of a compound statement for different inputs of the component statement. For example, let's say, if I say both my P and Q are true, what can you say about P conjunction Q
or one.
P and Q? That will also be true. Yeah, one for you is true. Okay.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Okay. What about this is true, this is false?
This and this.
False.
False.
Yes. Because until unless, see, if I say 18 is divisible by 6 and 18 is divisible by 5. That means it is divisible by 6 and 5. You will immediately say false for this because it is not divisible by 5. Okay. If P is true, P is false, Q is true, then also this is going to be
false.
And if both are false, then definitely is going to be false. So the only occasion when your conjunction is going to be true when your conjuncts both are true. When your both the conjuncts are true, then only your conjunction will be true. Okay. Now let me tell you, all statements containing AND should not be taken as a connector. Okay. For example, water and oil do not mix well. Here AND is not acting as a connector. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
All the ANDs as connector. By the feel of the statement, you'll understand that it's acting as a connector or not. Okay. Now, next connector that we're going to talk about is basically a disjunction, or we can say OR connector. OR connector, also called as the disjunction. This was done. represented by the symbol down arrow. Let me give you an example. Let's say I give you a statement. Venkat is smart and lucky. Smart or lucky. Okay. Now here, you may be both. Correct?
Yes, sir.
So there are two types of or which we normally come across in our English language. One is called exclusive or, another is called inclusive or. What is inclusive or? The statement which I gave you, this is actually an inclusive or. Because you can be both. Okay. But if I say a statement like, Nagma is dead or alive, it is exclusive or, because she cannot be both at the same time. Okay. Or something like, I will stay at home or I will go out to see a movie. That is an example.
Oh.
Correct.
Home theater is not counted.
Yes. So there you cannot include both the situations in the statement, but here you can say, yes, Venkat can be both smart and lucky. Okay. And let's say there is something wrong with the bulb or with the wiring. Now both can happen. There may be something wrong with the bulb as well as with the wiring. Okay, so that is inclusive or. So in our discussion, I will talk about inclusive or. I will not talk about exclusive or. Okay. Is that fine?
Yes, sir.
And again, please do not treat every or as a connector. For example, I'm going to watch the movie Sita or Gita. So here or is not really the connector. Okay. What about the truth table of this junction? Let's talk about it.
It'll be true, false. False only when both are false.
So true will give you a true. True, false will give you again a true. False, true will give you a true, and false will give you a false. That means only when the component or the constituent statements are false, then only your disjunction will be called as false.
Yes, sir.
Now, something very important here. What is the negation of a disjunction? Sorry, conjunction. I claim that the negation of a disjunction, the negation of a conjunction is basically disjunction of their negation. That means both are equivalent.
Oh, the Morgan's law.
This is actually the Morgan's law. Morgan's law. Can we prove this? In order to prove that any statement is equivalent to another, or you can say this is the symbol of logical equivalence, you just have to show that their truth table are the same. Okay? Can we now do a truth table of this guy and show that the truth table of these two match? So what I'll do is, I will make a truth table of this P, Q, P and Q. Sorry, before that I'll make not P, not Q. Let's say not P, not Q.
Yes.
What happened, Venkat?
No, sir, I just got a crick in my leg.
Okay. Not P and Q. And finally, we'll make it up not P or not Q. Okay. And then check whether this column and this column matches or not. So let's take the process of how many inputs we have for P and Q. Remember, it's always 2 to the power n.
2. Oh, that way, yeah.
So if there were P, Q, R, let's say then it will have 8 inputs. Okay.
Hmm.
Let's say true, true. So what will be this? False. True. This will be false.
False,
which is false. Correct. Then true, false. This will become false, true.
False, true.
False. This will become a true.
This guy will be true. That will become a true. False, true. Yeah.
False, true.
True, false. True and false.
False, yeah, false. then true.
True.
Then this is also true. Correct?
Yeah.
Okay.
False, false.
Finally, let's talk about false, false. False, false. This will be true, true.
True, true. False, true, true. False.
Correct?
This will be no.
And this will be true.
Oh, yeah.
Correct? No. So as you can see, these two columns exactly match. That means these two are logically equivalent to each other. A lot of questions will be asking you whether the following which of the following statements are logically equivalent or not. Okay. So there, please remember to do it by truth table.
One sec, sir. This is some 1 second. Copy this, sir. I'm looking at you. I'll take screenshot.
Yeah, please.
Done, sir.
Okay. In a similar way, following De Morgan's law only, I can say negation of a disjunction is logically equivalent to conjunction of their respective negations. Okay? I'll leave it to you as a question. Please prove it using TT.
Scientific examiner.
Is that fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now comes the important part. So far we were doing funny activities, but now comes the serious part of this chapter, which is called implications. Implications are also, you can say, compound statements, but here the connectors are not the and or the or, but it is something like this. Let me give you an example of an implication. By the way, implication is also called conditional statement. Okay, so let me give you a typical example of implication. If it rains, then I will not go out. Okay. As you can see, this is made up of two component statements. One is it rains, and second, I will not go out. Okay. So you can say this is one statement and this is another statement, Q. Okay. And if P then Q is symbolically represented as P single direction arrow Q. Okay. Where P is sometimes called the antecedent. Okay. Many book will call it as hypothesis. Okay. Many books will also call it as the premise. Okay.
Premise. Oh.
Q is called the consequent.
Precedent. Oh, okay.
Consequent. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Some books will call it as the conclusion. Okay. Now, why it is called a conditional statement? Because for the second statement to happen or for the conclusion to happen, there is a precedent to that or antecedent to that. Okay. And remember, it is the direction of the arrow is only one side, it doesn't go the other way. Right? What does it mean? It means that P is a sufficient condition for P, but Q is a necessary condition for P.
What, sir?
I'll give you an example. I'll write it down. P is sufficient condition. Sufficient condition for Q. But Q is a necessary condition for
P.
Sufficient means it is sufficient that if P happens, then Q will happen. Right? But if Q happens, P may or not. Are you getting my point?
So try no, to sir.
Let me give you an example. If it is a Sunday, okay, then school will be closed. Okay. So if somebody tells you that, hey, today is a Sunday, then what conclusion can you draw about the school being open or closed?
Pakka closed.
It is definitely closed. Pakka closed. But if somebody comes and tells you school is closed, does it mean it has to be a Sunday? Not necessarily. It may be closed because of some, right? It may be closed because of some, you know, riot in the town.
Coronavirus.
It may be closed because of coronavirus. It may be closed because there's some leopard on the road. Are you getting my point?
Yes, okay, sir.
So this is a sufficient condition for this to happen. And this is a necessary condition for this to happen. Are you getting my point? Okay.
Yes, sir.
It doesn't mean it is fulfilling the entire requirement. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
We can also read it as P implies Q. Okay. That's why it is called implication also. So you can also read this as P implies Q. Okay.
One second. Sufficient.
Have you done this in school?
No, sir. We spent like 35 minutes on this chapter.
Oh, okay, okay. This is the most important part because a lot of questions will be framed on this.
And even a final exam is coming for like 1 mark. 1 to 2 marks, that's it.
Maybe also one question will come, not more than that.
But that'll be a sure shot question, right, sir?
Sure, sir. You'll definitely get 4 marks there.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Written.
There's no need to write down, Venkat. I'll be sharing this with you. Don't worry. Okay.
Oh, seriously? Then chill, man. I'm not writing.
Listen to me. Enjoy this chapter.
Okay, sir.
Now, there are certain things which are associated with implications. So, when you say P implies Q, okay, let's say this is an implication. There are certain terms that we need to understand. If you write this ulta, we call it as converse of this implication. Okay. Now remember, if P implies Q, P may not imply P. That means if this is true, this may or may not be true. Can you give me an example? If this guy is true, then this guy may not be true.
Wait, 1 second, sir. Like 2 minutes.
2 minutes.
Figure it out. Oh yeah. So if X died because of coronavirus, mm-hmm. Q implies P. X died doesn't mean he died because of coronavirus.
Okay, I'll give you my very related example. If a number is divisible by, what has happened to my spellings? Yeah, divisible by 9, then it must be divisible by 3.
Yeah.
Okay. But can I say the vice versa is true?
No.
If a number is divisible by 3, it may not be divisible by 9. For example, 6. Okay. So, my dear, that's why in class 9, when you were proving theorems, you had to prove their converse also separately. Are you getting my point? So, when I was like studying in my class 9th, all these proofs of triangle and circle, there was a proof that if you draw a perpendicular on the chord, it will bisect the chord. Okay, then there was a converse of it. A perpendicular from the chord must pass through the center, like that. So I was very frustrated that time. Why are we proving the same thing, ulta and sida, two times? Because of the fact that if an implication is true, its converse may not be true. Are you getting my point? We'll soon see the truth table of it also. Okay. Next type of statement which you'll come across is something which we call inverse, which is like if not P, then not Q. This is called the inverse of the implication. Okay, let me give you an implication. You tell me what is the inverse of it. If it is cold, then I will wear my jacket. Okay. Tell me, what is the inverse of this statement? Tell me, what is the converse also? Okay. Vidyota has given a statement. So the inverse is, if it is not cold, then I will not wear my jacket. Very good, Vidyota. What about converse?
If I'm wearing my jacket, that means it's cold.
Yes. If I wear my jacket, then it is cold. Okay. Now the third one is what we call as, if not Q, then not P. You can call it as the inverse of the converse, which we call as contra-positive statement or contra-positive of this implication. Okay. So if I have to write a contra-positive for this statement over here, what will I say? If I don't wear my jacket, that means it is not cold. Are you getting my point?
Yeah. Yes, okay. Sir.
Now, just a question up front. Which of these three means the same thing as the statement itself?
Contra positive.
Okay, so the answer to that is yes, contra positive, but we'll see that through truth tables. Let the truth table tell me that this and this are logically equivalent. First of all, let us see the truth table of if P then Q. Truth table of if P then Q. So listen to this very, very carefully. It may be surprising to some of you.
It might be?
Surprising,
okay.
If P and Q both are true, what do you think is if true or false?
True.
If this is true and this is false, what is the answer?
False.
If this is false, this is true, right?
False again.
It's true.
Oh.
If this is false, I don't think it'll be surprising.
It'll be surprising, yeah. False.
True,
yeah, it's double negative becomes positive.
Okay, now
doesn't happen the other thing, da.
No, I know, but
English rules are like that.
Yeah, Dheeraj and I'll explain you how it happens. Okay. Let's say,
yes, sir,
there is a husband who makes a promise to his wife that if I get a promotion, then I'll take you to Singapore for a vacation. Okay. Singapore for a vacation. Now, tell me, when does a husband become a good husband?
When he keeps up his promise.
Of course, when he keeps up his promise. So let's say he gets a promotion. That is true. He takes his wife to Singapore. That is also true. Is he a good husband?
Yeah.
Yes. If it is a good husband, write a true there. Okay. Now, if he gets a promotion, but he doesn't take his wife to Singapore, is he a bad husband or a good husband? Bad husband.
Bad.
Bad means false. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Bring the point. If he doesn't get a promotion, poor fellow, but still takes his wife to Singapore.
Nice guy.
Super god husband, right?
Yeah, but also poor husband.
Than that fellow. So again, write a true. And if he doesn't get a promotion, and he doesn't take his wife to the Singapore, that doesn't make him bad, actually. He actually fulfilled what he said. That's true. Okay. That's a funny way of remembering it. But the idea is, if the antecedent becomes false, we do not care what is my consequent. Whether it's true or false, we do not care. Your implication will still be
true.
For example, if I say, if you study, then you will clear IIT. Okay, then you will get into IIT. Okay. Now, if you studied and you got into IIT,
peace.
Then no problem, right? Peace. But if you studied and didn't get into IIT, then definitely you will come and shout at me. Sir, you said you studied, didn't get into IIT. I studied, but I still didn't get into IIT. So if the antecedent is true, but the consequent fails, then only you will come and shout at me. Right? Then only you will raise a question. But yes, if you study, and let's say you cleared IIT, that means you will be still happy, right? Because, you know, antecedent here is false. That doesn't mean your consequent cannot happen. Just like your school. If your school is closed, it need not be a Sunday.
Oh, okay.
Okay. And if antecedent is failing again and consequent is failing, then it is basically doing whatever is required from the statement. So if you don't study, you'll not get in. Simple as that.
Yeah.
Now, I would like you both, not both, all of you here. I actually thought two people are responding, so two people are there in the class. I'm sorry. So now I want you all to make a truth table of if not Q, then not P. Please make a truth table for this and verify whether it is getting as what we got over here. I want you to give me the truth table for this. When you are ready, let me know. Let's do one thing. Why to do only this? We'll do all the three. We'll do this also. We'll do this also. And we'll do this. So that we can check which of the three that we had discussed, converse, inverse, and contrapositive, is logically equivalent to the implication.
Okay, so will this table just be the like bottom to top for the above table?
We'll check. I don't remember the exact answer.
I mean, it depends on how you start and stuff, but okay.
Should we discuss now?
Wait, sir. Q implies P. And the, yo.
Can we do it together?
Okay, sir. Yeah, that's better.
So, just the truth table of Q implies P. So, read it the reverse way. Promotion takes his wife. Good husband?
True.
Yeah.
Didn't get a promotion, takes his wife. Good husband?
Yeah.
Gets promotion, doesn't take his wife. Bad husband. Get promotion, doesn't take wife. No. Not P implies not Q. So read it like this. False, false, right?
Yeah.
False, false.
Yeah.
True.
True.
False, true.
False.
False.
False, true, true.
False, true, true. Oh, yeah. Correct.
False.
Yeah.
Yeah. True, true, true.
So you took that antecedent thing as Q, right, sir?
No. I'm talking about this guy.
Oh, okay.
Not P is false. No, not Q is also false. So false means not getting promotion, not taking wife. Good husband, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Now false, true means not getting promotion, still taking his wife. Good husband, true. True, false. Getting a promotion, not taking the wife. False.
Bad husband. Getting a promotion, not taking. Yeah.
This one. This one you have to read the other way around. False, false.
Good guy.
True. Top and bottom will always be like same.
True, false.
False.
Bad husband.
Yeah.
False, true.
True.
False, true. Yeah, good guy.
Okay. Now you can see here very, very clearly that TFTT and here also TFTT. While the others are not giving TFTT. What does it
mean? Sir.
It means to us that P implies Q is logically equivalent. So many books write it like this. Many books write it like this. Both are fine. It's logically equivalent to saying if not Q, then not P.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Is that fine?
Sir, I have a request from you, but in this page only, 2 minutes you can you spend, sir?
Why? Yeah,
since you are giving this notes. But 1 second. So for this and this, I don't know how to tell this, but I won't, for me in future reference, replace P with Q, that statement.
Yeah, this and is, this is your husband's promise, and then this is your wife taking to Singapore for this guy.
Yeah. Okay, sir. 1 second. For my future reference only. I hope no one will mind. Anyway, you are giving this to us. Pen. Pen, yeah.
Okay.
1 second, sir. 1 second.
Okay.
Wait. Done, sir. That's an E, by the way. No. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
What about the negation of this?
Okay. Negation.
Negation of this, I claim that this is same as saying P happening and Q not happening. Okay. Let's try this.
By how, sir? How?
Let's verify this. Okay. P, Q. P implies Q. Negation of P implies Q. Okay. And P and not Q. So let's say true. What will be this, by the way?
True. Good husband.
What is this? False. What is P and not Q? Not Q is false, right?
Yeah.
Correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So far, false, same. Now let's see true, false. Bad husband?
Yes, sir.
False.
Negation of it is true?
True.
True and negation of false.
True and true, that is, true. Which is true.
Okay. Now false, true.
Nice guy, damn nice guy.
Nice guy, this one?
False. Yeah, and false.
False and false. This is false again.
Yeah.
Then finally.
False and false.
False and false will be true, and then
true. This will be
true. True. Okay. False. Sorry.
True. False.
Yeah. False.
Do you see that this table and this table exactly, this column and this column exactly match? That means, yes, they are logically equivalent. And it's common sense also. If you say P, if P then Q, then the ulta will be P happening and Q not happening, isn't it? When is the only you say, sir, you said if I'll study, I'll get into IIT. I studied, but I did not get into IIT. So that will be the negation of what has happened. Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Kind of, I don't know. Damn weird. Okay, sir.